Hey, brother.
All of a sudden, I'm here at my... Wait, are we at Mashup Summer Camp?
Yeah. My parents dropped me off for... I'm off school for the next 6 weeks. They dropped me off. Told me, don't call home.
Well, I'm glad you guys are here and that you've registered for Mashup Summer Camp. We're actually announcing when everybody's going to be put in the cabins on the 20th, but this is our second year of doing this. So thanks for coming down to the camp to take a look.
That's unbelievable.
We're happy to be here. I brought a lot of spam in case you get hungry.
Well, we do have the dining hall, so please eat that in the dining hall. We've actually had problems with people eating in the cabins.
Yeah, well, in this bunk, it's all beef bratwurst for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, my friend. All beef.
Well, I don't know if you guys know, but Mashup Summer Camp is all about making mashups. You guys know what a mashup is?
Is it like mashed potatoes?
It's a little, it can stick to your ribs for sure, but mashups can be your friends if that's what you mean in a Weird Al Yankovic sense.
Is that kind of like how I mash up all chicken fed beef chicken nuggets?
Well, I guess you could put beef on one turntable and chicken nuggets on the other and come out with some kind of a constituted food product that would taste delicious.
As long as it's all beef, brother. Namaste.
I was about to say, we have some fantastic counselors at Mashup Summer Camp that'll make sure that all beef is squashed. Nothing but good feelings here at Mashup Summer Camp.
Love it. We have vegetarian spam, too, in case anybody's a veg head.
We take food allergies pretty seriously, but, sometimes those ingredients can present problems, for sure.
So anyway, what's a mashup?
Well, a mashup is you take all the songs that you love and you throw them together and you see what sticks. But really, it's about listening to more than one song at once and it sounds fantastic. Can I give you guys an example?
Yes,
okay,
please.
Okay. I think I'm catching on. I think I'm catching on.
Okay. Well, like good example. Say you guys are a band, right? You're Fantastic Plastics.
No, I'm Bulk Shogun. I'm a proprietor of an old beat.
And I'm your old pal, Spamela Sanderson.
Well, I'm sorry. You know the band Fantastic Plastics?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I've been told that they're around here somewhere.
They signed my paychecks.
And I wanted to hopefully show off, a little bit of something earlier tonight. By the way, I have a third arm that comes up here out of my shirt.
I've got a third leg.
Well, you keep that in your pants. Anyway, Madonna was here earlier. I had to, kick Madonna off because, they were getting in the way of the plastics. And man, that Madonna doesn't know when to quit, let me tell you. But take a little bit of something like this. And then you mix together a little Fantastic Plastics. It sounds like this.
That slaps.
Wait for it. We gotta get Madonna in here. I've heard she's backstage, but she's coming. Oh yeah, here she is. She's coming up around the corner. Get to the mic, Madonna. Madonna, we do all this live with actual celebrities. Yeah, here we go. There's a little Miranda.
Yeah, let's hear the Miranda.
And like I said, you can take...
All right. I think I got it. So, like... All right, so I can, like, mash up Brother and Sisters. Oh, I went Beavis there. I could like, mash up the Alphabet song with Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, I think.
Sure. I mean, do you have a DAW?
I think that's blocked in my region.
You're definitely going to need some editing software, or you could find those two songs on vinyl and try to mix them together live.
All right.
If you ever need DJ lessons, just get together with me, Bulk Shogun. I'll show you the ropes, brother.
And where could someone find a guy like you?
Well, you can either go to PDSMIX.com, which is my website, and they'll give you some links on other places to find me, like my social media network. Networks, and or I'm mainly here on Twitch, just like Fantastic Plastics.
Twitch.tv/PDSMIX.
Woo! Yes, that's the one.
She's hype.
I'm very hype. I love that song. I want you to burn me a CD of that, please.
For sure. I'll make it available for the entire plastic party. How does that sound?
Ooh, yes, please. Thank you. I'm gonna play it at the club.
The club.
That's right.
All right. Well, look, I gotta get back to my bunk. We're gonna.
That's right. Get settled in because we'll be announcing which cabin you're in. Right now, you guys are just hanging out here on the veranda, you know, of the cabins. And on the 20th, we will sort everybody into cabins. You can go to the Discord. There's a link there in chat that Gojira should be able to put up. Right there in chat. And join the Discord, and you can register for summer camp for...
Brother. We're bringing the Discord this summer.
Everybody join the Discord. Join the camp. Let's go.
And, please. I'd love to have the plastic party.
Check your local grocer for Bulk Shogun's all chicken-fed beef chicken nuggets.
There's a lot of proteins at this camp. They're on the loose.
We'll have the exterminator out later. They multiply over the winter.
Hey, hello.
There he is. The legend.
The legend. The one and only PDS Mix, everybody. Woo!
Hey! So glad to be here. Wait a second. Am I actually on the ship?
You are. You're inside the thing.
I'm inside the ship and you guys are... Oh, there you are. Wait, are we in a different ship? You're on a TV? I don't know. I don't want to know how the magic works, but I'm glad to be here.
Woo! Thanks so much for being here.
Nom, 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 nom. Oh, sorry. All that food was delicious.
Yeah, this is the green room. Feel free to snack on anything that you see, except for Shelvis.
A lot of people might not know, but a lot of my shows are like center around food. Like Disco After Dark, we have the salad bar. Goth Taco Mukbang, which will be returning this fall, is all about tacos, and I eat actual tacos on stream. And then on Fridays, we have a pizza party where you guys and some lucky person buys a pizza for all of us, and I share it through the magic of a plugin for Chrome and Firefox, where you can reach through the screen and grab yourself a slice.
Wow, that's incredible. That's technology. Oh, there's a slice.
Nom, nom, nom. So delicious.
That's pepper.
Sorry, I can't control myself sometimes.
Oh, it's okay. She's delicious.
So, do you guys have just a second? I want to show you something.
Yeah.
I might have to turn off the channel.
Yeah, sorry, guys. They're just all the characters are excited to
look,
see
you. If the plastic party wants to feed me, then, you know, please bring it on. I need the food.
Creme de menthe shake over there if you're interested.
Ooh.
Refreshing. Sorry, Shelvis.
So one of the I've been making mashups since 2001, 2002, something like that. So you know, 20 some odd years, probably a little bit, I've been DJing for just a little bit longer than that. And when the pandemic happened, you know, my IRL business kind of got shut down, and I, like many DJs, pivoted here to Twitch. I have a feeling you guys did the same kind of thing, you know, with your band. And I don't know, as long as I can stay here, I'd love to do it. I know that Twitch is putting together a DJ program that's going to make it easier for DJs to stay, and that will help promote that there are DJs on Twitch, just like there's bands like yourself on Twitch. I wanted to share with you probably just a snippet of a mashup that was one of my more popular, something that people enjoyed. And you want to hear it?
Yes, please. Definitely.
Here it goes. All right, everybody, put your lighters up. Come on, let's go. Everybody, meet Alpaca! One of the many Dancimals on the channel, if not the leader of the Dancimals.
Hello, Alpaca.
So that's a little sample of Bubble Bottom Girls. Made the booty year-end chart, I think in like 2016. And then, of course, I know you guys are Devo fans, right? You know the band Devo? Have you ever
heard of them? I never heard of them.
Show us, come on now. I know that you're the king, but...
Hey. Keep your hands and your eyes and your mouth off of that creme de menthe. Turn the man in my boot.
Well, you know, you probably know Whip It, right?
Oh, yeah.
I'll whip your ass and touch that turn the man.
So, Whip It's kind of a fast song. I do believe it's like 79 beats per minute. And so sometimes with mashups, you gotta slow things down, right? You gotta slow things down. And what I did was I took...
Yeah.
I took that, and you know the band Ministry?
Heard of them.
So Ministry, I take this and do this.
Oh, nice.
So again, just a nice little test there. But how about this? Let's slow something of yours down, since we have got some stuff together, and do.
Yeah, that was amazing, by the way.
I was ready to dance.
there's so many of your songs, because I listen to you guys every Friday and tune in, whether, you know, I'm speaking or not. Usually it's just in lurk mode. I'm there in the back. But a lot of your songs remind me of other popular songs. And that's one of the reasons I do what I do, is like, there are so many songs that remind me of other songs just because the musical language of, you know, sharing songs back and forth and sparking inspiration and creating songs, right? Mm-hmm. Well, I listened to one of your songs and I heard this. So take a listen.
All right, we're going to dance.
Okay, right. Let's do it. I'm realizing, hold on, I've messed this up.
It's pretty funny. I mean, unexpected mashup. It
made me feel a little drunk.
Yeah, you slow the Ramones down, you know, sometimes it's, I only did that because your vocals on that song remind me of Spider-Man. I always wind up singing it sometimes.
Oh, yeah, I could see that.
So...
nice.
There's that.
This is awesome.
Yeah.
If you want something to dance to, let's do one more Devo track for you.
All right.
And then we'll talk about something else. Here's something to actually dance to. Do you guys remember the old movie from the 80s? Dr. Detroit. Yeah,
oh, yeah,
Dr. Detroit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And,
with,
you know,
Dan Aykroyd?
Yeah. And you know,
I've never heard of it.
You've never heard of it? Really?
He's being... funny.
And no,
funny.
I think he just guessed, like Dan Aykroyd being in it, because he was in everything in the 80s, right?
True.
Anyway, so Cool Mo D, you know, the rapper, somebody came to me and was like,
yes,
why isn't there any Cool Mo Devo rap mashups? And I was like,
oh,
okay, I can make some Cool Mo Devo. Let's go.
I love it.
So let's dance to this. Here we go.
I was walking down the street, rocking my feet, clapping my hands and stomping my feet. I saw a little lady so neat and petite. She was so sweet, yes, I wanted to meet. So I asked this lady, could I take her out? We could wine and dine and talk about the birds and the bees in my water bed. And you could treat me like a Buddha and bow your head. We continued to talk again. Before you knew it, we were at my house and it was time to do it. As soon as I finished, I lost the poise, ran outside. Listen up, fellas, come over here, bust it. They said, did you get it? I said, yeah. They said, how was it? The boom thing was dope, and you know that I rocked her. But 3 days later, go see the doctor.
Thank you for a ride.
3 days later,
squeezer.
Go see the doctor.
Squeezer.
3 days later,
squeezer.
Go see the doctor.
Squeezer.
I rocked her to the left, rocked her to the right. She felt so good.
That is amazing, dude.
Yeah, that was so good.
Hold on, let me play you. There's a section of this that you guys have to hear. I'll skip forward. It's the bridge.
The bridge.
Go see the doctor.
Here we go.
Yes, that was so good.
Oh,
so there you go.
Amazing.
Yeah, I've got hundreds of mashups past that. And again, most of, or at least half my shows for summer, Mashup Summer Camp and Hits Different, are going to be all mashup based. So if you like that
Incredible.
Kind of thing, I will continue to spin it here on Twitch as long as they allow me to.
Well, I like hey, I like mashed potatoes. I like mashed potatoes too.
I've heard that they mean something. Do they mean something to you?
I mean something.
mean something.
These knuckleheads around here are always messing with a good old Shelvis. Broke nose Shelvis.
Shelvis, I heard you spell the word potato differently. I'm just kidding, Shelvis. I'm just kidding. I know you can't spell.
Hey.
Carrots and potatoes.
You hear that carrot?
Hey, well, there is the carrot.
Yes. I'm going to eat that TV dinner.
Auto carrot is kind of my nemesis.
Oh, yeah. Explain the carrot to us, to those who are new here.
Carrot kind of materialized one day because for the longest time, you know, autocorrect, you know, the changes, you know, your words as you're trying to type, and it makes all your words come out wrong for all your friends. So you're saying like duck instead of, you know.
Yes.
Yeah. One of these days, you know, I started calling autocorrect auto carrot because, you know, as like, you know, as a joke of like, you know, it would misspell its own name. Mm-hmm. And then one day, all of a sudden, auto carrot showed up in the Discord as a real entity and started correcting everybody live. And then shortly after that, last year in Mashup Summer Camp, auto carrot became a physical being and started showing up on screen. And now Auto Carrot kind of follows me everywhere I go, hence Auto Carrot being here tonight.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah, I love it.
So a big shout out to a Fnog Champ, by the way, for being here. I've heard that a Fnog Champ knew somebody who knew somebody who knew somebody that told Auto Carrot about me. Should I be mad at Fnog Champ?
Maybe.
I don't know. People love Auto Carrot, but they simultaneously hate Auto Carrot. Do you have somebody like that? Yeah, that you love, hate?
We kind of do. He likes Devo a lot, though. But he's a little scary.
He's fine.
Just to warn you.
He's fine.
Oh,
not,
no!
Not this guy. But
I was about to say, feed this guy some chicken burgers.
He's got the munchies, though. But fantastic plastic. Okay.
Fire, get out of my face.
We're doing a show here, dude.
Get out of my face.
Fantastic plastics, let me in.
Come on. Feed them more. Guys, you have to feed them chicken burgers for him to go away.
All right, that'll work.
That's right.
J'ai faim.
Okay.
All right. Well, look, tell us when you stream. What's your schedule?
It's super easy. Before, you know, as I was trying to do earlier streams because, you know, doing shows late at night for 4 years really kind of like messes up your sleep schedule.
That's true. Yes.
So my doctor was like, you might want to try sleeping. It could be good for you. Spring and winter, I changed to earlier hours. But now that I've gotten some things under control, it's going to be 5 to 8 p.m. Central. So that's 6 to 9 Eastern and then 3 to 6 West Coast on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Fridays, and Sundays.
Oh, wow.
Again, Tuesdays is Hits Different, where we play. The first hour is all mashups made within the last week by myself and a cast of hundreds or if not thousands of mashup producers across the world. Second hour is mashups made within that month. And then the last hour of that program, because all my programs are a 3-hour program, is mashups from any time period, right? Wednesdays, of course, is going to be Mashup Summer Camp. And Mashup Summer Camp is not just on screen, but it's a mixture of the Discord camp and the on-screen camp. So there will be challenges, including for people who are handy with an audio editor or know how to do some fancy DJ stuff, make mashups for your cabin, for the camp, and just summer mashups. And at the end of the year, we always put out a compilation of all the stuff that's been made at Mashup Summer Camp.
That's so cool.
And there's on-screen games. Last year, we had a canoe race that allowed people that were on teams, like, because again, each cabin is a team, and you have your own keyword, and if all your team shows up, you can get your canoe across the screen before your other cohorts.
Very fun. So, I love the audience participation, the interactivity. That's so fun.
Fridays are pizza party, where again, we spend, that starts at 4, but you know, if you just remember 5 to 8, Central across the board, you'll know. So Friday's pizza party, it's all vinyl 80s. So we'll be going to my 8,000 records that I have here at the house. and playing nothing but 80s jams. And then, of course, you guys always show up on Sundays for Disco After Dark.
Oh, yeah. We love Disco After Dark on Sundays. That's our tradition.
It's boogie. It's sleaze. It's Italo disco, high energy, electro funk, and classic disco. And we have, and I've heard that Zagat and Michelin have both claimed it is the best salad bar on Twitch.
Wow. Oh, we need a round of applause for that. Best salad bar on
Twitch.
Thank
you.
I have one quick question.
Yeah, go ahead.
I want to know, like, when you're off duty, what do you like to listen to? Like, let's say if you go for a little summer road trip or something, what's on your personal playlist
so
lately?
So here's a really honest answer, and that is that since the pandemic, I have never wanted for a soundtrack because there are so many great DJs and bands on Twitch that I generally just load up Twitch and find myself a DJ, someone that I trust to, you know, play me new music or play me my favorite music. And of course with Twitch, you know, you can interact and, like, you know, make requests and stuff like that and tip them and stuff like that. So yeah, Twitch is basically my soundtrack. I'm a multi-genre person. So like, I like everything from harsh noise to bossa nova, you know, hip hop to bebop, Devo to Bjork to, you know, Tupac, you know, it doesn't matter. What about you guys? Oh, goodness, what?
I don't know. We change our taste all the time, too.
We definitely went through like a 2-year phase of like mostly like 60s bossa nova and then late 70s, early 80s Italo disco. Thanks to yours.
Yeah,
you turned us
you
on
really,
to that.
Yeah, that's right.
Italo disco is so
Love
fun.
It. That's it's, our it's, chilling out music.
Yeah, another great DJ that I've just recently found that anytime they're on, I'm like just a huge fan, is a streamer called Moonworm. That's M-O-O-N-W-Y-R-M, Moonworm. They don't speak on their streams because of a personal preference, but their jams are just impeccable. Fantastic
Moonworm.
Stuff.
Yeah, we'll
Moonworm.
Definitely check them out.
We look forward to seeing you at camp.
Yeah, remember, anybody can come and register and be a part of Mashup Summer Camp. And we're going to be announcing what cabins you guys will be in come Thursday, the 20th. All of my programming changes seasonally. So the summer solstice, the 20th, and we'll be doing Mashup Summer Camp and Disco After Dark until fall for the vernal equinox, which is like, what, September 12th, I think?
September 21st.
September 21st.
Equinox.
Yeah.
You're going to get us tossed for talking like that.
Thanks for having me on.
Uh-oh.
Bougie, baby, what are you doing here?
I don't know. I just sit around here waiting for someone to show up and change my diaper.
I was wondering what the smell was. It oddly smells like lavender.
That must be your upper lip.
Well, ooh. Possibly. I had a lavender milkshake for lunch.
I've been saving all of my baby food jars.
What are you going to do with your baby food jars?
I have all of your toenails.
Wait, you have all of my toenails?
All the ones you cut
twice a
year.
You've been collecting my toenails?
Yeah, you should cut them more often.
What do you do with my toenails?
I'm making a suit of armor out of them.
So what would you, like, what would you be defending yourself from with my toenails? Are they effective?
They're sharper than shit.
We'll be right back to PDS Messages. Wow.
Okay. Wow.
I think we have to ban Bougie Baby.
Yeah, that was...
Yeah.
Way too much.
Yeah.
Way
Thank you
too
so much.
Much,
everybody. That was so much fun, though. I love the mashups. Like, I'm obsessed. They're so amazing. Everybody give PDSMIX a follow if you haven't already, and join his Discord. Join the camp. It sounds like a blast.
Check your local grocer for bulk Shoguns, all chicken-fed beef chicken nuggets.